Lizzie Magie was born in 1866 in Macomb, Illinois.
She had a close relationship with her father, an abolitionist and writer.
Her father had traveled with Abraham Lincoln and participated in debates. Through the mentorship of her father and Lizzie's own determination and intellect, Lizzie developed her political and economic acumen.
Throughout her life, wrote, invented, created, and acted. She engineered a device for a typewriter and received a patent for it in 1893.
Lizzie Magie created a game called the Landlord's Game, with two sets of rules. One set of rules had a winner-takes-all land-grabbing philosophy, and another allowed for greater equality.
The game was meant to advocate for a more just system. She patented the game in 1904, and after her patent expired and the game had become popular throughout college campuses, in Atlantic City neighborhood parties, she again patented the game in 1923.
But it wasn't enough. Charles Darrow and the Parker brothers would disregard her contribution and rewrite the story.
Played Monopoly around the world. It's in 114 countries and 47 different languages. So it's a very, very global game.
Hasbro acknowledges that Monopoly was inspired by Lizzie Magie, but since her death, her story has largely been lost to history. Charles Darrow is the one who rolled the dice and got all of the credit.
Over 100 years after Lizzie's first patent for the Landlord's Game, in February 2015, the New York Times reports that amid the press surrounding Darrow and the nationwide Monopoly craze, Magie lashed out. In 1936 interviews with the Washington Post and the Evening Star, she expressed anger at Darrow's appropriation of her idea. Then elderly, her gray hair tied back in a bun, she hoisted her own game boards before a photographer's lens to prove that she was the game's true creator. Probably if one counts lawyers, printers, and patent office fees used up in developing it, The Evening Star said, "The game has cost her more than she made from it." In 1948, Magie died in relative obscurity, a widow without children. Neither her headstone nor her obituary mentions her role in the creation of Monopoly.
Feet 3 inches, well proportioned.